Imagine being able to perform the cleanest card at any number ever with a borrowed shuffled deck. In 2004, Alakazam and Mike Rose released an effect that took the magic and mentalism world by storm. In our opinion, the Grail is the best card at any number ever created. And since its release in 2004, the Grail by Mike Rose has continued to be one of our best ever sellers. Over the years, Mike Rose and my dad have been tweaking the effect, creating new handlings and presentations. And almost 20 years on, we are proud to bring you the ultimate Grail collection. Inside this package, you receive everything you need to perform Mike Rose's original Grail routine, the killer Grail Gold routine, Dad's two-deck synergy routine, a handling for stage, and now, for the very first time, Dad is revealing all of his work on his closely kept secret, how to perform the Grail in an impromptu situation with a borrowed shuffle deck. That alone is worth the price of this, trust me. Now, if you want to see what the impromptu version of the Grail looks like, check this out.
Emma, deck of cards, if you take them out of the box and remove the jokers for me, I'll take the box back, that's great. And then have a look through the deck, just make sure it is a regular deck of cards and give them a shuffle. Have you ever been to a gambling house before?
No.
You haven't?
Never.
Now, there's a big problem with card cheating casinos. You've probably heard of it. And one of the things they can do is they can do what they call ringing in a stack deck. That means they switch their deck with the casino's deck. Right. Now, a stack deck means they've put every card in a certain order, so they're always going to win or they've got a good chance of winning. And the way that you shuffled it, we call it an overhand shuffle, which is what everyone does, but it doesn't actually break the stack. So if you ever go to a casino, the way they shuffle is to cut the deck itself into a few portions. So they could have, we'll do four piles, and they would end up shuffling these piles together. And they do something that they call breaking the stack. And the way they do it is they now separate the cards. So if the cards are in a certain order, they're now being separated, okay? In fact, give them another shuffle. Just make sure you're happy that they're being shuffled. And they will start taking cards out randomly, maybe from the middle. They can take cards from the bottom if they wanted. You know, they can take cards from anywhere as long as they're random and they are just being dealt and separated. You get the idea, okay? Now, this deck of cards now has been shuffled so many times by yourself. So they're in a random order.
Yeah.
And there's a little bit of information that you might not know, and this is absolutely true. This deck of cards, in the order you've shuffled them, will never be in this order again. You can shuffle this deck for the rest of your life, every minute of every day, and you'll never get them into this precise order. So that means that every card in there is in a position that it hasn't been into before, relative to the other cards. Now, I've got a lucky playing card, which I carry a photograph of in my wallet. Now, that card is obviously in here somewhere. We're going to try a little experiment. It's my lucky card, it never lets me down. Give me any number you want between one and two, and it can be any number.
Five.
Number five. Is there any way I could have known you were going to pick number five?
No.
Okay, pick up the box. Open it up. Take out the cards and turn them face up, so I want you to see everything and make sure I'm not cheating you. Can you deal five cards onto the table? The three of clubs.
Yeah.
Okay, just have a look through the deck. Make sure there isn't another three of clubs.
Nope.
No, it's a regular deck. You shuffled them into this order.
Yeah.
You chose the number five. Remember I said in my wallet, I've got a photograph of my lucky playing card. You can see there are not 52 different photographs in there. There's one photograph and you can see it right here.
Mm-hmm.
You chose the three of clubs. My lucky card has always been the three of clubs.